Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of the Jazz Transcription Clinic Podcast Live Practice with the Jazz Giants. Today I'm going to practice with you a solo that I transcribed a couple of months ago, and you can click on the link in the description of this video to find the video of myself actually transcribing this solo. It's the tune Remember, as played by Hank Mobley, and today we are going to practice with Hank Mobley his solo. You can also download from my website the entire transcription in either B flat or E flat. Let me know if you need it in concert or in F, if you want to play with the French horn, for example, and I'll be able to make it for you. And a donation when you download a transcription will always be appreciated, as well as a click on subscribe to my channel and a like, possibly on my channel. So let's dive into it, and I'm gonna start with the last A of the second chorus into the third chorus, because as you can see, it's quite dense, and maybe some of these lines require a bit of extra practice. So I'm going to start looping this section from one bar before the last A of the second chorus into basically the first A of the third chorus. As usual, you should know by now, but I'm using a platform, a web platform called SoundSlice, where I do my transcription and I use them to practice my solo. So I have uploaded the transcription here. There is the YouTube video here on top, and here down here you would see the speed control. Let me just open this window for you. Why it's not showing? Maybe I can pull it up a little bit. All right, and let me clean this for you. All right, that should be better. You can see there is a button speed called speed here at the bottom, and is set at the moment to 70%. So what's going on at the moment when I click start here in the solo? It will start from here and will loop this section at 70%. So if you are happy, I'm going to start the video and play and practice with Hank Mobley. How exciting! Let's go! I think we can go back to top. So all I do is to cancel the loop, and this is the top of the solo. So as usual, let me see whether it finishes. All right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to loop everything. So select everything, basically. And then I will use the speed control to play. Here, if I click on speed, there is speed training. There you go. Initial speed 70%, final speed 100%, increase speed by 10%. Each speed plays one time. Right? And I think we are ready to go. So we will play the whole melody and solo as played by Hank Mobley. First time at 70% speed, and then we will go back on top at 80% speed, back on top 90% speed, back on top full speed, 100%. Let's go. Good luck. Have fun.
Thank you. Thank you.
Have some work to do, but it's a good fun. And now I would like to show you some more things that you can do with a solo transcription. So in order to use this transcription to absorb some of the lines and the phrases and not become just a replica, just someone who can play like Hank Mobley, we don't want that to happen. We want to have our own sound, our own phrasing and distinction. But we are learning the vocabulary of jazz through the transcriptions. So a great exercise that you can do is to try to play the transcription and apply, let's say, 90% of the actual transcription and 10% of your own ideas. It can be a different rhythm, it can be a different approach to the phrase, it can be a different ending of a phrase. So let's start to play one chorus, one track, one run, and we play 10% of our own ideas. I'll give you a very, very simple example. Like at the beginning you have, can do, right? Simple as that. Just try to be creative using that as just a trace for your own ideas. But we only add 10% for now. Let's try it. Thank you. was 10%. Maybe I can try one more, and let's say I go to 30% of Hank Mobley, of my own ideas, and I'm lucky because I have still 70% of the great Hank Mobley. Let's try it. To practice jazz solo and jazz transcriptions, because you start questioning your mind, how can I look at that line from a different perspective, a different angle, and possess that line that eventually, with some time and some practice, will come out in your phrasing, because it has become a word in your jazz lingo, in your jazz vocabulary. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel, to follow my podcast, and see you and hear you next time. Bye.